We are back with another request on the channel. This time, once again, from Lucas Sherbank of Press to Enter. I know I finally said it right this time. Press to Enter are an extremely technically gifted prog metal band with a female lead vocalist, which is something you don't see all that much around here. So once again, I'm really excited to go in and check these guys out. They have a new album out now that I haven't checked out in its entirety. So we're gonna go in and pluck out a few songs. The request I received was their most recent playthrough video of their song, The Try. And I've heard some great things about the song Frozen Red Light as well, which I believe is their most popular off of the new album. So I'm gonna dive into that one right after. Let's start off with The Try over here. I don't know what to expect because the two songs I've heard already were extremely different from each other. They were so technical, so busy, but well executed. And I don't know enough about the band to say anything else. So let's just jump straight in. Thank you so much, Lucas, for the request once again. All the support, and all of you guys gotta go check out their album if you enjoy this kind of sound. So let's see what The Try has to offer. Press to Enter. Come on. Let's do this. You got some slap bass coming on to the prog scene? I am feeling that bass right now. We got ourselves in a nice little pocket. The groove just kind of stagnating a little bit. Still 4/4 though. Bass lines reminding me of like some of my favorite 80s songs. I reject feelings before they're understood. I don't have signs that guide the interesting key change. Got a huge atmosphere. Synth coming in. What? Like the words that I force, you keep lying. The bass is just getting slappier. So much harder just to say. We're not gonna just skip over that transition. I don't know what is going on there. Nice. I like that little crescendo there. Basic triplets. I would love to play along to just an isolated bass track in a song. Lucas is going off. Liking the more pure vocals here too. Wow. There's no way that's the end. That's beautiful. It feels really hopeful and kind of warm. The two things every modern prog song needs, man. We need happier, more hopeful music. Everything soundscapes like circulating around my head right now. Oh, ooh. So warm and lush, all the purples surrounding me in this part. I love that transition. Is this near the end of the album? This is very triumphant. Is that the end? Look at everyone laughing in the music video. These guys, man. They definitely have fun with their music. That's always the first thing that comes to my mind, especially looking at all this. They have reached that point where they have mastered their instruments. They're so technically gifted and they can go so many avenues with their music. They just throw these little spicy elements in just to make it enjoyable for themselves, for them to have fun with what they're doing. They clearly love what they're doing. I wish we could see more bands expressing that so obviously, that they're just loving what they're doing. There was some excellent playing in there. The slap bass, those little bass fills and the licks just going through the whole thing, the tone. Way it was accenting in between the drums, just beautiful. Some of that build up during the outro and that middle part of the song was excellently crafted. The one thing that does come to mind with me, I wish the vocals felt a little bit less processed. I love the lush and the warm sound they're going for, but I don't know if the vocals need that entirely. Her notes are so pointed and pure. There's not a lot of vibratos going on anymore or shifts in her notes. They're very pure. They're very holistic. Goes from one note to the next. So with it shining through with that much power, I don't know if it needs to be that saturated around it too with the sound, but it still sounds great. We're gonna move over to the Frozen Red Light playthrough now. Let's check this one out. Let's go. Frozen Red Light by Press to Enter. It's never enough to slow down. The screaming cars are passing. That is sketchy, man. Got some of those nice cleany elements in there. Bass, dude. These guys, yeah. This is a talented group, man. Really nice groove. What's going on with the drums though? It's not just hi-hat going on back there. This is a tight groove, man. I love this part. What the hell? How are you gonna bust out that riff during a verse and sing over it? It's so complicated and layered. That was sick. There's no way that's the only time they bring that out. I do like when bands kind of bring out some of the chorus melody in the intro, so when they bring it back it's familiar, you can kind of hook onto it a little. It's nice. Synths, man, such a warm atmosphere. I keep using the word warm, but it's just what it gives me. It's cozy. It's cozy, but it does still make you think quite a bit. Meryl coming up. I don't know where we're going, but... Woven web, anyone? It is very different, though. I mean, like, structurally similar, of course. You can tell influences are in there with Pliny, animals as leaders, etc. But, like, it is woven in a different way, the structure of everything. And that was not what I expected. I think maybe that was rendition of that riff I was talking about earlier that they had in the background of the verse. But it sounds so good. It's so tight. We're going back. We're going back. That, like, thumb plucking technique, I will never understand that. It is so impressive to me. That is so nasty. Whoa. They got everyone soloing at the same time. Whoa, time signature, hello. That was a necessary, like, 1.5 seconds of breathing space. The drummer is going crazy. Oh. We're going back. What? You know that's a difficult part to play when they're not bouncing around and smiling playing it. It's just the singer there just enjoying her break at the end of the song. That was awesome, guys. Wow. There's some craziness going on there. There was some super cool stuff in there, man. The bass technique and all the different grooves they layered in there were super impressive. As I've said through this whole reaction, through my last one as well, these guys are just so gifted. Watching them have fun doing what they do just gives me even more hope for the future with these kind of bands. With the way they're not letting anything affect them except themselves and their music and their passions. That riff in the middle, that very woven web, what the hell? That woven web type riff in the middle was just beautiful, beautifully executed. So chunky, and the way it was just guitar going through there instead of a full-on bass groove, like I believe it's full-on just straight bass groove in the Animals as Leader song, but here it's the guitar going in there and then the little accents from Lucas on the bass. It sounds amazing, and it was a very unexpected break, though it did make sense. Of course, they teased it a little bit during the verse, which made it really effective for me. That intro and red light turning into the chorus, really nice, sounded great. That was probably my favorite part of the song besides that riff. And the grooves all the way throughout the try, that nice buildup going through the whole song, and the way they reimagined each chorus made it a lot more engaging for me. Again, I think the vocals might be the only thing I'm not quite grasping onto. They have a very kind of Haken style delivery in the way every note is monotone and pure all the way through until they go on to the next one. And a lot of people think that is the ideal progressive voice. I know they love style of singing in Haken, but for me, that's something that I was never able to figure out. It didn't really appeal to me very much. I like vocals that have lots of expression, lots of dynamic shifts, and not necessarily vibratos, but just being able to contort yourself to the music, whatever you want to make it do, have some diversity in it. And there were just so many harmonies and fixations over it here that it didn't appeal to me as much as others, but it still sounds great as a whole because it does match the sound. It kind of goes in line with the keyboards in a lot of ways. There's some excellent stuff to be had here in the future, and just thank you so much to Lucas again for the request. You guys gotta go check out this band. I think fans of Haken, fans of Aviations, Pliny will all enjoy this group, and they're just starting to really come up now, so let's keep this going. That was The Try and Frozen Red Light. Until next time.